Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. In everyday life, we use informal definitions when describing shapes. For example, these objects are round, so we call them balls. But in math, we try to use formal definitions for shapes. In this video, we'll discuss what is meant by these terms: sphere, cylinder, cone, pyramids, prisms, 3D objects, and the common parts of some 3D objects. We'll start with a sphere. We would say that these objects have a shape like a sphere. That's the name we use for a very smooth ball-shaped object, regardless of its size and whether it's a real ball. In the formal definition of a sphere, it's perfectly smooth and round. It can be hollow or solid. These marbles are very smooth and round, so they're also spheres. The surface of the Earth isn't perfectly smooth, since there are high mountains and deep valleys, but from far away, the Earth looks smooth and round. So we say the Earth and all the planets are shaped like a sphere. The top half of the Earth is called the Northern Hemisphere, and the bottom half is called the Southern Hemisphere. On our math tests, the test makers often draw a sphere like this. The line around it is like the equator going around the Earth. The solid line is in front, so we can see it. The dotted line means that we can't see that part directly, because it's on the other side. The second shape we'll discuss is a cylinder. These batteries are shaped very similar to a cylinder. So are these cans of soda drinks. Like a sphere, a cylinder can be hollow or solid. The cans of food or drink are hollow cylinders that have a top and bottom. In metalwork, we call these rods, but in math, we call them cylinders. For elementary school, we only consider cylinders that have a top and bottom, like the metal rods, can of corn, or cans of soda. On our math tests, the test makers often draw a cylinder like this. The dotted line in the back shows a curved line that is invisible to us, since it's on the back side of the cylinder. All cylinders have a circular shape at both of their ends, called a disc. We use the word base to refer to the discs that are on each end. Next, we'll discuss cones. We commonly call this an ice cream cone. More specifically, we might say it's a waffle cone. This safety marker is a cone. This device also has a cone shape and can make someone sound loud. These party hats are cones. A cone shape has a circle at one end and a point at the other end. The pointed end is called the vertex. We call the disc its base. Its sides are curved. As with the other shapes, a cone may be hollow or solid. On our math tests, the test makers often draw a cone like this. The dotted line in the back refers to the curved line that we can't see directly, because it's on the back. Next, we'll discuss pyramids. These Egyptian pyramids were built thousands of years ago. Pyramids are similar to cones in that both have a point at the top. Just like with a cone, we call that top point a vertex. But with a pyramid, there are many other points which we can think of as corners. Each one is called a vertex. The plural name for vertex is vertices. The lines between vertices are called edges. There are several edges that go between the top vertex and the vertices along the base. And we can see several edges in this view that show edges between the vertices on the bottom. Like a cone, a pyramid has a base, which is the name for the bottom surface. But unlike a cone, every surface is flat. There are many types of pyramids. We name them based on the shape of the base. If the base is a triangle, we call it a triangular pyramid. You may also hear of a very special name for this shape. It's called a tetrahedron. This is how a triangular pyramid might look on a test. The one on the right was used on an actual state exam. The dashed lines are edges in the back which we can't see directly. Its base is the shape of a triangle. If the base is a square, we call it a square pyramid. This is how a square pyramid might look on a test. The dashed lines are edges in the back which we can't see directly. Its base is the shape of a square. These are two examples from actual state exams. If the base is a rectangle, we call it a rectangular pyramid. This is how a rectangular pyramid might look on a test. The dashed lines are edges in the back which we can't see directly. Its base is the shape of a rectangle. Please note that the side walls of all pyramids are made of triangles. This is true for all pyramids, regardless of the shape of its base. This is an important way to tell the difference between pyramids, cones, and a triangular prism. Instead of using the word wall to refer to the sides, we often call them faces. This is the name we use for the sides of pyramids and also for prisms. Many test makers also consider the base to be a face, especially for pyramids and prisms. As with all the shapes in this video, pyramids can be hollow or solid. Next, we'll discuss prisms. You may have heard of a famous experiment in which Isaac Newton used a glass prism like this to separate white light into the colors of the rainbow. The word prism refers to the shape of an object, not what it's made of. All of these wooden shapes are types of prisms. Like with the other shapes we've studied in this video, a prism can be hollow or solid. As with pyramids and cones, we use the word vertex to refer to the sharp point on a prism. A prism has lots of vertices. Just like with the pyramid, we use the word edge to refer to the lines between the vertices. And also like a pyramid, we use the word face to refer to the flat surfaces of a prism. The base is also a face. Here are common prisms we learn about in elementary school. Just like with pyramids, each prism is named according to the shape of its base, which we'll describe in further detail in the next section. This gift box is a prism. Its top is a base, and its bottom is another base. Please note that unlike pyramids, prisms have two bases, not one base. The bases on a given prism are the same shape, and they are located opposite from each other. These packing boxes are all prisms. Unlike with pyramids, in which the faces touching the base are always a triangle, with these prisms, the faces that are touching a base are either rectangles or squares. This is a triangular prism. That's because both of its bases are triangles. The sides between the bases can be shaped like rectangles or squares. A familiar example of a triangular prism is this red one made of wood. This is how we draw a triangular prism on paper. The drawing on the right is from a state exam question. The dashed lines are edges that are on the backside. This state exam question shows us that for all of the shapes in this video, we can draw them with any side up or down. This is a square prism. It gets that name because both of its bases are squares. One of the most famous examples of a square prism is a cube, in which case the faces between the bases are also squares. Ice cubes and sugar cubes get their names because of this shape. A familiar example of a square prism are these yellow wooden blocks. This is how a square prism might look on a test. The one on the right is from a state exam question. This is a rectangular prism. It gets that name because both of its bases are rectangles. A common example of rectangular prisms are domino blocks. The faces between the bases are also shaped like rectangles. This is how a rectangular prism might look on a test. Sometimes we call this a cuboid. The one on the right is from a state exam question. This is a pentagonal prism. It gets that name because both of its bases are pentagons. The faces between the pentagons are rectangles. This birdhouse has a shape that's similar to a pentagonal prism. A pentagon is a particular shape that has five sides. The front wall is one pentagonal base, and the back wall is another pentagonal base. These bases are connected by rectangular faces. This is how a pentagonal prism might look on a test. This is a hexagonal prism. It gets that name because both of its faces are hexagons. The faces between these hexagonal bases are rectangles. A hexagon is a particular shape that has six sides. Honeycombs are hexagonal prisms. In this view, we can't see the top and bottom bases, but in nature they're present. This is how a hexagonal prism might look on a test. The one on the right was used on an actual state exam. Next, we'll discuss the term 3D. When we say something is 3D, we mean that it has three measurements, one for length, one for width, and one for height. For example, the letters that this child is putting on the fridge are 3D because they have a width, length, and a height. In contrast, the same letters on a piece of paper only have two measurements each, a length and a width. They don't have a height because they're flat. So we say that the ones on the paper are 2D. The letter D stands for dimensions. A regular printer can only make shapes that are 2D, whereas a 3D printer, such as the one on the right, can make shapes that are 3D. All the shapes we learned about in this video are 3D. We've covered a lot of terms and definitions in this video. It can take time to learn these names and recognize these shapes. We encourage you to rewatch this video a few times if needed. Thanks for your attention.